The filter hides all unwanted rows so you'd only see the data that you need. That way, you turn big data sets into smaller ones that you can actually take action from. Here's how to insert and use a filter in 3 simple steps. Let's go. Casper from Spreadsheeter here, and the first step to inserting a filter is just to select any cell in your data set. Now, step number 2 is to go to the data tab up here and click the filter button. And now you'll see all these little filter buttons in each of the headers in the dataset, like this one. So the third step is to actually use the filter after you've inserted it. You can use the filter in several ways, but there are mainly 2 ways of doing so. And the first one is that you can click here and you can check or uncheck these checkboxes to determine what is shown in the dataset. So if I only select Abigail, like if I remove the check marks here and make sure there's a check mark in Abigail Bartnick and hit OK, then I can only see the sales from Abigail. Now I can actually filter even further. So if I only want to see sales from Abigail, but only orders that did not have only 1 unit in it, I can just do this and hit OK, and it's done. Now I've just turned a big data set into a smaller one with a filter. Before I show you the second method, I just want to give a quick mention to my free online Excel training. Just go to my website and scroll down the page to select what level you want to start with, and I'll send you 30 minutes of free online training directly to your inbox. Go to spreadsheeto.com/YouTube if you want to check that out. Now for the second method of using an Excel filter, and that is to use the filter to actually sort the data. So clear the filter. You don't have to do that every time, but now I want a clear data set here. So I can sort this by either the order number or any of the other numbers in here. So maybe I want to see the data set sorted by the biggest unit price. Then I just click here and click sort largest to smallest. And that's it. Now I've sorted the data set using a filter. Pretty cool, huh? YouTube thinks this is a great video for you to watch next. If I were you, I would click it, because YouTube is usually right about stuff like that. Also, if you like this video, please click the button below to subscribe. And in the description, you'll find a link to my free online Excel course. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.